Let's talk about metrics. After watching this video, I also recommend to watch our funnel video because it will be like extension for this one. So metrics, what is it? It's specific indicator that we can measure with sufficient accuracy. The idea is just if we can measure, we call it metrics. If there are no accurate indicator, not accuracy, it means this is not a metric. So what kind of metrics we have? Usually we separate them to four categories: business, growth, product, and vanity. And sometimes we can separate as well marketing metrics. But also we can include marketing metrics in business, growth, or product metrics. Let's talk about every category. So business metrics. Yeah, firstly, of course, it's income. So total income, business interested in total income. Also is monthly and annual recurrent revenue, MRR and RRR. The idea is just when somebody buy your shared hosting company or your cloud business, usually they see monthly recurrent revenue or annually for easier. Sometimes, for example, for many kind of services, people pay on an annually basis. But for some services, people pay monthly. And the idea just when investors see at your company, our business owner, usually he, of course, he interested in new sales, but mostly monthly recurrent revenue, it's most important because it's also show your retention. It's also show that you have a small drop rate and how big is your constant revenue. For example, for hosting companies, they sometimes multiply it by 2 years, sometimes 3 years, sometimes 1 year. But recurrent revenues, it's most important one. Also, of course, profit. And as you see here, North Star metric. About North Star metric, I will record separate video. I also recommend to watch this because North Star metric, it's metric number one. Metric that matters. By the way, the Amplitude company strong giving list of these metrics because usually people calculate these metrics using Amplitude. So that was business metrics. So what kind of growth metrics? Growth metrics is like MAU, DAU, WAU, and of course North Star metric as well. So it's like monthly, daily, or weekly active users. So it depends on your project, on your product. Because for example, for Facebook, it's very important to calculate daily active users because people come here daily. For accounting software, it could be possibly monthly because people need to come every month to fill data. Some of them comes every day, some of them comes every hour. But at least we need to calculate people who comes monthly because they do report for tax offices monthly. And of course, for some like newspapers, let's say people should come every week because some of them, let's say, read you on Tuesday some specific topics. Some of them come on Friday to see other kind of topics. For different projects, the main metrics could be different. Okay, and of course, with Grow metrics, we also see here North Star metrics that I will explain in different video, a separate video. So what next? Product metrics. What is most important product metrics? Firstly is lifetime revenue, lifetime value. So it's usually easily calculated, it's just every check multiplied to retention. So usually your every check and how many usually customer pays until he leaves you. Sometimes people calculate this only for 1 year when they calculate unit economics. About unit economics, it will be a separate video, but unit economics means like that we need to get more money from customer than we spend for that. So we have LTV and CAC. So customer acquisition cost, it means how much we buy customer, and LTV, how much we get money from customer. Usually it's for the first year, but it also could be calculated for the whole period. And but let's start with LTV. Also, there are C1 metrics. C1 metrics, it's conversion from registered users or from active users to payment. Also, retention, it's the same like C1, but it's C2, C3, C4, C5, C6. So it means like when person pays second time, it's C2. When he pays fifth time, it's C5. We call it retention. Also, what is about retention? It's very important to know that retention could be also about payments and about users' visits. Let's say if we talk about payment, we're talking about payment retention. It means like how many times users pay and like calculate how many of them decrease. When we're talking about, let's say, news portal, we maybe do not calculate user payments, but we calculate how much customer like comes, for example. He comes, how many, let's say, months is he comes to our portal. So it's, we said, retention is how he addicted to our product, how long he will come back to our product and to visit us. And sometimes if you need to track like brand, for example, you spend lots of money for branding, you can also study a little bit brand lift metrics and like what is it and how to use it. So this is main ones for product. So let's come to vanity metrics. So what is means vanity? People usually provide huge, nice numbers, but these numbers do not answer any questions. Number of installation. We have 2 million installation, but without time, for example, is it 2 million in 5 years, in 1 week? So we just cooked. We have 2 million installation. Is this user active? Nobody knows. And these metrics do not provide any logic information. And for example, page views. We have, let's say, 5,000 page views. Or 500,000 page views. Okay, maybe people just come here and click to close it. For example, maybe they bought an ads. People just open it. Oh, it's bad website and close it. But they still have 500,000 of users monthly or daily or annually. And of course, time on the website. For example, when you a Facebook, time on the website is your money, because as much people spend money on YouTube or Facebook, so users get ads all this time. So it's very interesting for them. But for other products, let's say Uber, they don't need lots of time in Uber. People, when they need a taxi, they just go to Uber. They need taxi as fast as possible. So time for Uber, like how many time people spend in Uber app, is too complicated. Should be as small as possible. So for Facebook, if he come to Facebook to get customer as long as possible, but when he comes to Uber, the idea is to provide information for him as fast as possible. And if they both calculate time on the website, so what is the logic? So it's vanity metrics. But North Star metrics is not vanity metrics. So North Star metric, it's combined metrics. And as we see, it helps to growth, it helps to business metrics, and it helps to product. So with one metrics, we can cover all segments. So it's very important, and we will talk about this on next video. So thank you for your time. And just to explain, this was most important metrics for business growth. Of course, vanity, there are no most important metrics, and the product. Okay, see you on the next video.